and welcome to your second MindUP lesson of the school year. My name is Joni, and I'm a trainer for the Beach Cities Health District. And today, I'll be guiding you through today's lesson, which is all about mindful awareness and understanding the difference between mindful behavior and unmindful behavior. But before we jump in, I'd like to begin with a mindful listening exercise. So let's get our bodies in a nice, seated, calm, still position. Sit up nice and tall. Bring your hands to the tops of your thighs. And if it feels okay, you can close your eyes with me, or you can simply look down. Whatever feels best, meet me there. And then take a nice, big, deep breath in through your nose. And exhale, let it go. Great job. Let's do that one more time together. Bigger breath in and open your mouth and let it go. And now start to listen to the sounds around you, the sounds that are really far, maybe outdoors or in another area of your house. Listen closely to what you might hear. And now bring your attention to the room that you're in, the space around you, and begin to notice those sounds. And now bring your attention to the sounds right around your body and your chair and your little bubble space. Maybe you hear your breath, or the sound of your stomach growling. And then slowly you can blink your eyes open or look up. And I'm wondering, did you hear any sounds that you've never heard before? Or maybe never heard that loud? Sometimes we can be in a space so often, but we don't focus our intention on those sounds, and we don't focus on listening, so we simply don't notice it. Today, we'll be talking about doing one thing at a time and becoming more mindful and more aware of our behaviors so that we can act in a more respectful and responsible way. For today's lesson, you'll need quite a few materials, and those will be listed on the next slide. So take a look and we'll get started. Here are the materials you need for today. The mindful or unmindful worksheet, a pen or a pencil, scissors, glue stick, or tape. Here's a picture of each worksheet. We'll be referring to these worksheets a lot throughout the lesson, so be sure you have them nearby. On the top of your worksheet, you'll notice the heading mindful or unmindful. Your job is to decide whether or not the behaviors listed are mindful behaviors or unmindful behaviors. We are mindful when we think before we act. All three parts of your brain that we learned about in the first lesson, your amygdala, prefrontal cortex, and hippocampus, work together to help you think before you act. We're unmindful when we act without thinking. We aren't paying attention to what's happening around us, and our amygdala tries to do all of the work. During these times, it's hard for us to make good decisions. One example of being mindful is exactly what we practiced a moment ago, mindful listening. Maybe you weren't lying on the beach, but you were listening really closely and just paying attention to the sounds around you. Hi there, welcome back. It's time to complete your mindful and unmindful worksheet together. So grab both of your sheets. You'll need your mindful and unmindful with all the examples. You'll also need the blank template that looks pretty similar. It just has some openings on each side where you'll put your answers. So your job is to decide whether the behaviors listed are mindful or unmindful. I suggest labeling first as you go through each one before you start cutting them out. So let's do the first one together. It says rejecting a new food because it is unfamiliar to you. So I'm thinking if you're rejecting something without even having an open mind and you're judging that you're not going to like it, it seems pretty unmindful to me. So if that's what you were thinking, nice work. You can put a U right next to it to
to label it unmindful. And you can continue doing that labeling until you're finished, and then you can begin the cutting and pasting. As you can see, there's 5 on each side, so they should all fit perfectly. If for some reason they don't, I recommend having an adult check it over, or you can double check your own work. If you're still having trouble, you can rewind back to the beginning part of this lesson where it talks about the difference between what a mindful behavior is and an unmindful behavior, and that should help you as well. So get started, and I will see you in a couple slides one more time again to wrap up the lesson.
Here's another example from your worksheet, intentionally ignoring a classmate who seems eager to join your game or group. Mindful or unmindful? Continue reading through the rest of the examples on your own. Once you finish labeling each behavior, you can begin to cut and paste the examples into the correct columns.
Great work, you made it to the final video of this lesson, which means you've completed your worksheet and you're now an expert on mindful and unmindful behaviors. I hope you have a beautiful rest of your week and that as you move through each day, you set an intention or a goal to just act a bit more mindfully, to think before you act, to think before you speak, and help others around you do the same. I look forward to seeing you in the next lesson. Thank you.